Welcome to Omega Open Course. The conservation of angular momentum is one of the fundamental laws of physics, and many good problems of rotational dynamics requires one to use conservation of angular momentum. But majority of the students struggle while writing the angular momentum, and precisely because of that they find rotational dynamics the toughest topic in high school physics. In this video, we will discuss how to write angular momentum of any system about any given point at high school level. We will not be discussing what angular momentum is, that requires a separate video of its own. Our focus in this video is entirely on writing the angular momentum of a given system about any point. At high school level, in problems involving angular momentum, we encounter three different situations: pure translation, pure rotation, and situation where rotation and translations are combined. These three situations require three different approaches. Let us tackle them one by one. A body is said to be in pure translation if all points on the body move with the same velocity. In other words, a body is in pure translation if, when seen from its center of mass, the body is at rest. So if this block moves in such a manner that its orientation does not change during the motion, then the body is in pure translation. It is not important whether it is moving on a straight line or along a curve, its orientation must not change during the motion. In both these cases, if you look at the block from the frame moving with the center of mass of the block, you will find the block to be at rest. But it is moving if such that its orientation is changing, then the body is not in pure translation. As you can see in this case, when seen from the frame moving with the center of mass of the body appears to be rotating. So different points on the body are moving with respect to the center of mass. This implies all points on the body do not have same velocity, and hence the motion is not pure translation. Now suppose there is a body in pure translation. Let us call the line on which its center of mass is moving the line of motion of the body. Suppose we have to find the angular momentum of the body about a point. The magnitude of the angular momentum is product of linear momentum of the body and the perpendicular distance of the line of motion from the point. So if the mass of the block is m, its velocity v, and the perpendicular distance of its line of motion from the point is r, then magnitude of its angular momentum about the given point is mvr. So far the direction is concerned, we can use the same system as we used in the direction of torque. If you have not watched our video on calculation of torque, you should watch it once. It will help you deal with the direction better. The link for the video is shown on the screen and given in the descriptions below. In this case, if you look at the block from the point, you will find it moving in clockwise direction, and hence the direction of torque is clockwise. In case the block had been moving in opposite direction, the direction of angular momentum would have been anti-clockwise. But as in case of torque, this convention is only for the purpose of understanding. The actual direction of angular momentum vector is the perpendicular to the plane containing the motion and the point about which the angular momentum is being calculated. If the motion is in clockwise direction, the actual direction of angular momentum is into the plane. In case the motion is in anti-clockwise direction, the direction of angular momentum vector is out of the plane. Now let us move on to the case of pure rotation. If a rigid body moves in such a manner that there exists a point on the body which is at rest in our frame, then the body is said to be in pure rotation about that point. For example, when this disc is moving, the red dot on the disc is not moving. So the disc is in pure rotation about this red dot. Now suppose we have to find the angular momentum of the disc about the red dot. In this case, the magnitude of angular momentum is simply the product of angular speed of the disc and the moment of inertia of the disc about the axis perpendicular to the disc and passing through the red dot. The direction is simply the direction in which the disc is rotating, in this case clockwise. And as we discussed in the case of pure translation, if rotation is in clockwise direction, the actual direction of angular momentum vector is into the plane, and if rotation is anti-clockwise, the direction of angular momentum vector is out of the plane. Finally, let's consider a body moving in a manner which is neither pure translation nor pure rotation. For example, consider this moving disc. As you can see, there is no point on the disc which is at rest, so the motion of the disc is not pure rotation. Also, if you look at the disc from the frame moving with its center, the disc will appear to be rotating. So it's not in pure translation either. In such cases, the angular momentum of body about a given point is simply superposition of angular momentum due to translation of its center of mass about the given point and angular momentum due to its rotation about its center of mass. What this means is, first we draw the line of motion of center of mass and find its perpendicular distance from the given point. Let L1 be the product of linear momentum and perpendicular distance. So L1 is basically its angular momentum about the point, assuming it to be in pure translation. Also, the direction of L1 is clockwise. Then we look at the disk in the frame moving with its center of mass. In this frame, the disk is in pure rotation. So we find its angular momentum L2 in this frame by multiplying its moment of inertia with its angular speed. The direction of this angular momentum is anti-clockwise. The angular momentum of the disk about the given point is L1 minus L2. We have subtracted L2 from L1 because their directions are opposite. If the disk were rotating in clockwise direction, then angular momentum would have been L1 plus L2. It is very important to keep in mind that in case the body is rotating and translating simultaneously, the moment of inertia is always taken about the axis passing through its center of mass. It does not matter about which point the angular momentum is being calculated. So to summarize, the motion of a rigid body can be divided into three categories: pure translation, pure rotation, and having both rotation and translation. In case of pure translation, all points on the body have equal velocity. In that case, the magnitude of angular momentum about a given point is product of linear momentum of the body and the perpendicular distance of the line of motion from the given point. The direction of angular momentum is same as the direction in which the body is moving about the given point. In case of pure rotation, there exists a point on the body which remains at rest in our frame during the motion of the body. If angular momentum is to be calculated about that point, then it is simply the product of moment of inertia about that point and angular speed of the body. If the rotation is clockwise, the direction of angular momentum is clockwise. If it rotates in other direction, the direction of angular momentum is opposite. When the body is both rotating and translating, we calculate the angular momentum due to pure translation of its center of mass about the given point, and then the angular momentum of body due to pure rotation about its center of mass, and then we add it. If both momenta have opposite direction, we subtract it. The concept cannot be understood properly without examples. Shown on the screen is the playlist containing solutions of the question involving angular momentum. Watch these videos and try to understand how angular momentum is being written. You may also like to watch our videos on other theories, tools and techniques of physics. Subscribe the channel and like our Facebook page for latest updates. Thank you for watching.